Allow me to reintroduce myself. My name is
the game. Jeremy McWilliams, remember the name.
What's up, guys? First off, welcome to the video. For those of you that are new to the channel, my name is Jeremy McWilliams, aka MC Williams. And in today's video, as you can probably tell by the title, I'm just gonna go over a really basic overview slash tutorial slash step-by-step guide of how to ship a pair of sneakers or shoes that you sell on GOAT. First things first, for those of you that don't know, as you can see right here on the screen, GOAT is basically an app and a website that its sole purpose is to buy and sell authentic sneakers and shoes. If you're a shoe slash sneaker reseller, you probably already know a lot of these details, but for those of you out there that are watching this, that are just getting started with your shoe slash sneaker reselling journey, or maybe you've been in the shoe reselling game for a while now, but you're trying to get into the GOAT game, which can be a little challenging because as you can see right here on the screen, it says seller accounts, and then below, to ensure quality and authentic items, we only allow a select group of sellers. We encourage you to request to become a seller on GOAT by tapping on the Sell tab on the app and filling out the required information. We'll notify you as soon as your request has been approved. Now, for me personally, I don't remember exactly, but I know I applied on a couple different occasions to try and sell on GOAT. And I want to say, just off the top of my head, it took like 5 or 6 months before they finally approved me so I could finally start selling on GOAT. For those of you that are waiting, I feel your pain. Keep waiting, man. I'm sure some spots will open up soon. And when they do, I definitely highly recommend GOAT. Not trying to get too far off the tracks, but if you guys resell on eBay and you're looking to start reselling on GOAT, stay tuned to the channel because I'm going to do a video very soon comparing reselling shoes and sneakers on eBay versus reselling shoes and sneakers on GOAT. So, if that sounds like something you're interested in, make sure to stay tuned to the channel. Either way, let's move on with our day. Alright, so now that we got that out of the way and everyone kind of has a basic understanding at least of what GOAT is, let's go ahead and jump into the simple process of what you need to do as a GOAT seller once you sell a pair of shoes or sneakers on GOAT. Alright, so as you guys can see right here, this is a notification GOAT sent me via the app on my phone that notified me a pair of shoes, or in this case, a pair of high-end Nike soccer cleats called Hypervenom 3 Elites in a crimson gray colorway. It says they just sold, and then you guys will notice right next to it, right here, it says just confirm. Now, just in case you don't notice the sold notification from GOAT on your phone, they'll also send you an email saying that your whatever pair of shoes it is just sold. And then as it said in that notification, it says please confirm order. And as you guys can see right here, it says please confirm the sale within 24 hours. If the sale is not confirmed within 24 hours, it will automatically, I'm guessing it's supposed to say, be canceled. So, as it says right here, to confirm, simply open the order tabs in the app, confirm the sale, and we'll send you your prepaid, pre-addressed shipping label. So I've actually already done that confirming process for these soccer cleats on the GOAT app, but I will go ahead and show you guys where it is, just so you know. So, first things first, click on the GOAT app, and then once you do that, right here it will say need to confirm, so you'll just go ahead and click on that, and then the order or orders that need to be confirmed will all pop up right here, and to confirm them, all you do is click on that specific order, and then press confirm, and that's about it for that step. Step number two, after you confirm your order, is go back into the app, and right here it will say need to ship or drop off, so go ahead and click on that. And then your orders that you've already confirmed will pop up here. So click on the order you're looking for. In this case, these orange soccer cleats. So we clicked on that. And then right here, it says generate prepaid UPS label. So go ahead and click on that. And then as you can see, a little message pops up asking you if you're sure that you can ship the order within 3 business days. As long as you're cool with that, go ahead and click on yes. And then this is what the screen will look like after that. And when you actually drop it off at the UPS store, you just click on drop off right there. The next step after that is go back to your email and then refresh it. And you should have an email from GOAT that should say your order number. And then right here, it should say shipping label and instructions. And as long as you got that email, you're good to go. Scroll down a little bit to where it says 4 easy steps. Click on step number 1 and bada bing, bada boom. the label pops right up, and you also have to print out sheet number 2. But for me personally, to print out these two pieces of paper, I use 2 separate printers. So for my label, I got my Rollo label printer right here, and then for the second sheet right here, I just use a regular laser printer over there. Now if you don't have a label printer like this Rollo, you can definitely still print off shipping labels as long as you have a somewhat new laser printer. And if you go that route and use a laser printer, I recommend getting something like this, which these are Avery internet shipping labels that I believe I got from Walmart or Amazon, or I'm sure you can get them at Target, probably any of those places. If you do want to use something like these shipping labels, I'll try and find a link for these exact labels on Amazon and drop it below. Basically, all they are is a white sheet of paper with 2 shipping labels. The front looks like that, back looks like that. You can see the 2 shipping labels right there, one here, one here. You just peel them off, slap them onto the box, and you're good to go. Now, like I said, something like this works perfectly fine, but if you're printing a lot of shipping labels, I definitely recommend grabbing yourself something like this shipping label printer, which if you're interested in the exact one I use, I'll drop that link below as well. And now it's the fun part, the printing. So let's turn this printer on. Make sure we select the right printer, thermal printer, that's it. And then for paper size, we're looking for size 4x6 right here. And then after that, go up to the top where it says pages, click on that, custom. And like I said, the shipping label is page number 1. So all we want is page 1 if you're going to use a shipping label printer like this one. So once you change the pages right here to page number 1, go down to print and bada bing, bada boom. It prints out super quick, super easy. And this is the final shipping label. So we got our 4x6 label, which just like the other ones, this is just a sticker. So when you're done packing your shoes, you just peel it off, slap it on the box, and you're good to go. So now that we printed off the shipping label, go down page number 2, and then you want to print this off as well using a normal printer, because as you guys can see right here, it says please include with your item when shipping. So we'll go ahead and print this off using that laser printer over there, so select that one and then click on more settings, because once again we just want page number 2. So go back to pages, click custom, and then enter 2, and as long as you got the right printer selected, go ahead and hit print, and there you go, you got your cover sheet. So like I said, make sure you keep this. I usually just fold it in half, and then once I have the shoes all packed, I'll just drop that on top, seal it up, peel the label off, slap it on top of the box, and then go drop it off at the UPS store. Now before we go any further, let me rewind it a little bit and point out one very important thing. Go back to your email that includes the shipping label and instructions, and scroll down a little bit. This line right here is very important. For these specific shoes, it says ship by Monday, April 19th, 2021. Failure to do so will result in an auto cancellation and review of your seller account. And trust me, they're not playing games about the auto cancellation. Unfortunately, they will cancel your order if you don't ship it within those 3 business days. So definitely pay attention to that date. And as long as you ship it / drop it off at the UPS store by that date and make sure they scan it, you're good to go and you shouldn't have any problems. Alright guys, so before I go ahead and wrap up this video, there's one more very important step that you need to do in order to complete the whole shipping process with GOAT. And that is go back into the GOAT app. And after you drop off that specific pair of shoes or that specific order at your UPS store, make sure you click on that order. And once you're in the app, once again, you can get to the order you're looking for by clicking on this right here where it says need to ship or drop off. So click on that, click on the order that you dropped off, and then you should see that right there that says dropped off with UPS. So after you dropped off at the counter, go ahead and click on that button and you're good to go for that order. And then a couple days later, you should get a notification from the GOAT app on your phone that looks a little something like this, that says your shoes have been authenticated by GOAT. And at that point, you're able to go into the GOAT app and actually withdraw the funds to your bank account. You can go back into the GOAT app, and right here where it says credits at the top, go ahead and click on that, and it will show you the total amount that you're able to cash out. And if you want to withdraw those funds / cash out, go ahead and click on the cash out right there. And at that point, you have 2 options. You can either have them directly deposit the funds to your bank account, or you can have them send it to your PayPal account. Whichever one's easier for you, doesn't really matter. And that is all there is to it. It's a really quick, easy, simple process. I highly recommend Goat. Up until this point, I honestly haven't had any problems at all with them, and everything's been really smooth sailing. So far for me at least, two thumbs up. I've had a great experience with them, and I have nothing but good things to say. And with that said, that brings us to the end of this video. So, like always, if you guys have any questions or comments, drop them below. If not, no worries. I'll catch you in the next video. Thanks for watching. Enjoy the rest of your day. Enjoy the rest of your night. Stay sane. Stay safe. And as always, stay limitless. Take a shot, you've got everything you'll ever need. You fought, you're not gonna let up on the speed. Those knots that got you were only make-believe. Those